Stop staring and start running! Oh, you can't, because you're underwater. Which is why I prefer to stay on land, where I may have access to insane cars when humanity is on its last leg. Don't worry, the apocalypse isn't here yet. That ticking sound you hear is actually from my phone. Hey everyone, and welcome back to LawTech Pro. If you're new to this channel, I do all sorts of G-SHOCK videos, from drop tests and torture tests to in-depth reviews, while also unearthing hidden features along the way, such as Multiband 6. Hear me out, I'm calling this a hidden feature because Multiband 6 only works in parts of Japan, North America, UK, and Europe. The great thing for those who live in areas covered by terrestrial radio wave stations is that unlike GPS, reception is possible even when surrounded by buildings. Signals are received during the night to keep the displayed time exact, so no manual syncing is required, and the reception is possible with less than normal power consumption, unlike Bluetooth, which severely drains the watch battery. For many who live outside the range of the terrestrial radio wave stations, perfect time synchronization was impossible, until now. To set the time on your Multiband 6 equipped G-SHOCK through a smartphone, just head over to the App Store and search for Radio Wave Sync. There are many similar applications, but I find this one works best, as it is free, easy to navigate through, and is specifically designed to be used with G-SHOCKs or other Casio watches. The description also includes a guide to syncing the time on your watch with the time on your phone. Alternatively, you could also use Clockwave or Watchwave, but they are paid applications. Do note, I do not get any monetary benefits if you download these apps, and I am not related to them in any way, and hence downloading them is at your own risk. For the sake of simplicity, I am only using an analogue digital G-SHOCK, the GWG 1000 Mudmaster. Digital G-SHOCKs such as the old Rangeman GW9400 have the same operation, and the analogue GWA1100 Gravity Master. So the first thing you need to do is set the home city to Tokyo or any other city which is covered by the terrestrial radio wave stations. The reason I am choosing Tokyo is because Casio is from Japan, and also because of the next step. I'll push the crown in and move on to the analogue Wave Ceptor. So I'll just pull out the crown and set the home city as Tokyo. On a digital G-SHOCK such as the old Rangeman, just long press adjust to set the home city on your watch. On this watch, it's already set to Tokyo, so I'll just push the crown back in. Next, head to your phone settings and search for date and time. Turn automatic time adjustment off and set the time zone to Tokyo, Japan. Now open the Radio Wave Sync application on your phone. I must warn you, there are a lot of ads. I've offset the time on my Mudmaster by about 7 seconds, so any change must be perceptible. Along with this, I've set the date as June 16th on the Gravity Master, even though it's June 8th today. Tapping the settings icon allows you to set the radio wave station. Since I already changed the time zone to Tokyo, I could choose auto, or choose one of the Japanese stations, or the ones in Germany, UK, and the US. There is also a paid beast mode, which as far as I am aware, does nothing. Hitting the question mark brings up the tutorial page, which in short tells you to set the phone volume to the max and choose the appropriate home city and radio wave station, which I've already done. On a digital or analog digital G-SHOCK, simply press the mode button to enter the receiving mode. I'll move the hands out of the way. This basically shows the date and time the watch was last able to sync with the atomic tower. March 26 to be precise in my case, when I actually synced it using the app. To start a manual reception, press and hold the bottom right button until the word RC stops blinking on the screen. If you're wondering how this works, there's no need. I've taken apart my Rangeman just to show you the antenna. It looks like a solenoid with its looped copper wires, which pick up the radio waves. Yes, the app uses sound waves. However, in practice, it doesn't really matter a lot. Here's a quick physics lesson for you guys. Radio waves are transverse waves, which move like this, but sound waves are longitudinal and move like this. The reason why this is insignificant is because the time is set using a specific frequency and pattern. The only downside is that the range is extremely limited, meaning you have to figure out where on the watch you need to point your phone speaker at, and stay silent throughout the whole procedure. For the Mudmaster, pointing the speaker at the back plate gives the high signal strength at a level 3. If you aren't hearing anything, it's because I removed the annoying audio for the rest of this video. It's the same procedure for a digital G-SHOCK, but I disassembled my Rangeman for a project I'm currently working on. Again, just press the low right button in the receiving mode to start a manual reception. the 12 o'clock position works best for the rangeman, according to me. And with that, I'm moving on to the Gravity Master. In this, the procedure is even more straightforward. Simply press the bottom right button once to check if the watch is synced with the atomic clock radio wave station, and the second hand will point to yes or no. To start a manual reception, press and hold the button until the second hand points to R. So there you go, the second hand is currently pointing at R, which means it's actively searching for the radio wave signals.
1 eternity later.
It's been a minute now, and the second hand is pointing at W, which means the watch is receiving the signals from my phone. There's no way of telling the signal strength on the Gravity Master. Though it's not required to direct the speaker towards the watch, it reduces the reception time. When I move my Mud Master away from my phone, the signal strength drops down to a level 2 or a level 1. So I will place these G-SHOCKs on either side of my phone, and I'll come back later.
2,000 years later.
It's been about 5 minutes since I started, and that's today's date and current time displayed on my iPhone, the 8th of June 2020. And the Gravity Master has finished receiving the date and time information from my phone, and is now rolling back the date dial from 16th of June to the 8th of June. It's extremely slow, so I'll speed this up a bit. The time has been corrected and only the date remains. The Gravity Master has set the time and date from my phone, and the whole process only took about 6 minutes, though if you point the speaker towards the watch, it takes less time. Oh, even the Mud Master is done. Let's take a look. On the Mud Master, it shows the date and time of the last successful reception, as GET on the 8th of June at 11:36 PM. There we go, the watches are perfectly synced with one another. Here's the two on either side of my phone. This is important because these and other older G-SHOCKs only have multi-band 6 for time calibration. That's it. Now all I need to do is set the G-SHOCKs and my phone back to my preferred home city. So simply unscrew the crown and turn it to select your original home city. In my case, it's Delhi. And screw the crown in to prevent water ingress. Switching over to my Mud Master, I need to do the exact same thing by unscrewing the crown, pulling it out to select the home city as Delhi, and pushing it back in and screwing it down. All this is left to do is turn on automatic time adjustment for my phone. If you're using this to boost the signal from a radio tower, you needn't do all this. But if you were in the range of a tower, why would you need it anyway? That's it for this video, guys. If you found it helpful, leave a like, subscribe to LawTech Pro, and hit the bell icon to turn your notifications on so you are alerted whenever I make a new upload. Thanks for watching.